The port of Los Angeles is an afterthought that paid off. Final decision to convert the mudflats of San Pedro came late in the city's development, in 1899. But the $200 million result is the newest, most modern, largest man-made harbor in the world. Capable of docking and working 85 ocean-going vessels at the same time, the port of Los Angeles is noisy and pungent. There is the clank of cars being unloaded from Europe, the smell of coffee from Brazil, bananas from Central America, newsprint from Canada. Minerals are exported to Holland, fruits to France, cotton and steel to Japan, machinery to Venezuela, and to the world, California wine and lumber, borax and oil. The pace of life and work in the ultimate city starts with a school system as new and as innovative as the environment itself. More tax money goes into education than any other single budget item, almost 50%. Result? One of the most diversified academic, cultural, and sports programs of any public school system in America. With almost all new structures and the most sophisticated educational aids, high school graduates are so motivated that 67% go on to a statewide system of junior colleges and universities, all uniquely located within easy reach of any Angeleno.
Los Angeles because I can go to the beach, the desert, the mountains, and the theater all in the same day. And where else can you do that?
Enthusiasm of the movie lot, the office, the schoolroom, and the construction site. The enthusiasm of working hard in Los Angeles is the same enthusiasm which is carried by sportsmen and sports fans alike to a seemingly endless variety of nearby playgrounds. Since 1958, seven major sports franchises have come to Fan City, Los Angeles. Pro football alone turns out 700,000 people a year to watch their Rams. And there are no rules about staying in the stands after victory. This too is Los Angeles, 4,000 acres of nature in the heart of the city. Griffith Park is but one of the more than 300 private and public parks and playgrounds close to the homes of urban families. Hey! Accessibility is a running theme. Marineland, 35 minutes by car. Disneyland is only 45 minutes away. Of course, if you want to add even greater variety to Los Angeles living, Hawaii is but 5 hours by jet. Mexico, 3 hours by car. San Francisco, two fast cocktails in the air and you're there. And Las Vegas, you may as well leave the seatbelt fastened. It's only 45 minutes. The La Brea Tar Pits in urban Los Angeles contain fossils of animals dating back to the Pleistocene period. On the surface immediately above the pits rests a time capsule of a somewhat different age. It is called the Los Angeles County Art Museum, a gallery with a personality designed for the jet age and beyond. Dedication to the arts overflows the museum's walls into more than 100 other galleries throughout the city, into the art treasuries on La Cienega Boulevard. Or into a movie star's backyard. Los Angeles children live in a city which has an average temperature of 64 plus degrees. An annual rainfall so low that when it does rain, they rush out to look at it. It's a way of life that could make the vitamin pill obsolete. Happiness in Los Angeles is a swimming pool. There are more than 100,000 of them, enjoyed many times over that number by friends and neighbors. Needless to say, the ever-present swimming pool keeps the ever-busy pool maintenance man happy too. At the end of a day in Los Angeles, the night places brighten with life. The brand new $34 million Music Center and the Hollywood Bowl are designed with a compelling elegance, which brings out the best in both audiences and performers. It takes a little while for the outsider to get used to it, the pace of Los Angeles nightlife, and that uncanny feeling that everybody looks familiar. Thank you. Angeles has a human and physical environment that calls for working hard and playing hard. It is a 24-hour enthusiasm that keeps supermarkets open all night and city services going constantly. A city of 3 million thirsts for water, thrives on electricity, requires police and fire protection. Responsibility for these vital services rests with the city government, a full-time mayor, and a legislative council. Running Los Angeles is a $640 million a year business. And unlike most other cities, the 15 elected councilmen meet every weekday morning. Mayor Sam Yorty has two offices, one at City Hall. The other could be hovering anywhere over a city that sprawls some 460 square miles.
I really lose track of the number of times city business necessitates my flying over Los Angeles. Yet I still am fascinated by it. During the day, it is always breathtaking. The bigness, the hustle and bustle, and the room for expansion. And the unique beauty, city, beach, desert, mountains, all within reach. Nighttime, well, that's something extra special. Like so many of our guests and residents, no matter how many times I've flown into this city at night, I'm captivated by the biggest, brightest, and most beautiful welcome mat I've ever seen. Day or night, Los Angeles is exciting. I think you're going to like it.